Sukam Power Systems Limited is an India-based power solutions provider which sells its products in more than 70 countries. After bagging several awards, today Sukam Power Systems stands as India's leading solar power solutions company, which sells through its network of 1,200 distributors and over 25,000 dealers. Hello and welcome to Yell Times TV. We have with us now Mr. Shaurya Sachdev, who is the marketing strategist of Sukam Power Systems Limited. So come, let's have a talk with him and let's see what Sukam has in store for his customer. Hello sir, welcome to the show. Sir, as we know that our first inverter that was made after many testing and measurement, that did not turn out to be so much of a positive. So that was when you all started inventing more on the technology for better products, and that is where Sukam came into being. And from that time onwards, as you all know, the Sukam inverters generally picked up the momentum. Yeah. So how was your experience in making the first inverter?
First of all, I didn't make the first inverter. Yeah. My father did. So for him, I guess it was a very different journey compared to the journey he's given us. For us, it's a made brand that we're trying to take ahead. But for him, he had his own challenges that when he made an inverter in the beginning, it didn't work. It actually didn't work. So as many times he fixed it, made the technology better, he made a base technology out of it, where he understood, okay, this is the base of an inverter. Once that base worked out fine, he developed upon that base. But for him to get from that spoiled inverter to the base took quite a lot of time and quite a lot of effort and hard work. But he was dedicated, he was very passionate about, because I don't know if you guys know the story, the inverter in his house conked off. So when that happened, he actually went and opened up his old inverter, and he understood that it's not that much of a rocket science. He could make that, and he was in the cable TV business. So from the cable TV business, he decided, okay, I will divert to inverters. And then he started focusing and he tried to build inverters, called some from China, from America, opened up all of them and saw what is the technology worldwide in inverters. And then he made one of his own from India.
As we know that Sukam has been into consumer financing to target its lower income groups. So how successful that has been?
So see, right now we have initially actually started focusing on EMI. We have come up with an EMI scheme where the customer can come and actually take the inverter for free and start paying the EMI from next month onwards. And obviously there's a certain interest rate charge, but for someone who cannot shell off 7,000 or 20,000 rupees for a solar plant or a expensive inverter initially, for them it's a big security. Okay, I can buy an inverter or a solar plant in a EMI process basis. And if we talk about financing, we do a lot of financing on the government end right now. We are now trying to reach the end customer. For someone like me, you, or any common person, they walk into a shop, they see the price of the product, it might be hefty for them, so they can take it on an EMI basis.
So that has been the core target in investing in the lower income group, like the EMI system.
Lower income group, I would say middle class, high class, or any class. See, today even if you buy a car, we buy it on a down payment, then we do an EMI. So same thing, we want to not be able to restrict anyone to buy an inverter or a battery or a solar panel. The EMI option is there in every industry now, if you see. In our industry, if you see, the focus has not been that much to the end consumer ki EMI model pe jana chahiye. So we're trying to focus on the EMI model, and we're really trying to market it a lot to the end consumer, that now you can actually utilize the EMI policy with these kind of products.
Okay, as we know that Sukam was the first company who has made a plastic inverter. So, and that innovation actually came in the list of the top 10 innovations in the decade 2010. So how was that experience?
So that experience my father can tell better, but I remember that the whole rumor that was there, that the whole advantage of that inverter was, see, before they were metallic inverters, and there was a big chance of getting electric shock. So if your child would be there in the house and he'd be walking around or playing around, there'd be a big danger that he could get a shock. The whole advantage of the plastic body was, first of all, the look, the aesthetics were different, and then the major advantage was safety. So the protection part of it, that your child can be playing in the house, anything can happen, but the inverter won't electrocute him. And if you see, even today with our products, we're still going with that plastic body model. We have the metallic body also, but we always integrate the plastic features for safety and for aesthetic looks.
And so as we know already that apart from UPS, stabilizers and inverters, Sukam has recently stepped into the solar sector also. So what does Sukam has in, what are the new products that Sukam has in store for its customers?
So for solar right now, India has a booming future, right? And for solar, we were already there 5 years back in solar with a lot of technologies that See, with solar, the challenge is explaining it to the end customer. Customer ko samjhana ki solar hai kya, solar kaise chalta hai. So we have a lot of products from, say, we have grid tie, we have a solar home UPS, where you can see we have a solar home UPS. And then this can be initially put as a normal UPS. And when the customer can afford the feasibility of putting panels, he can immediately go with it for solar. Then we have a grid tie inverter, where it's actually an inverter without a battery. So in that, if you think about it, it's you connect it to the grid, and jobi energy you will make, you will utilize it first in your house. Whatever excess energy you make, you sell it to the grid. So say if the Haryana government price is 7 rupees per watt, when you sell that energy to the Haryana government, that excess you will get paid for. So it's two types of incomes for the customer. One, he is running his full load on solar to the house. The second is that he sells the excess energy in the grid, the government pays him. So there's an income also and there's a saving also. And then if we talk about solar, we have this remote monitoring system. So all the solar projects, the big plants we put, you can monitor the systems remotely from anywhere. So I'm sitting here today, I can check what is the output of the 4 Huda metro stations we have installed our solar plants in. What is the output in terms of money, in terms of kilowatt? Are they facing any issues? Are the panels dirty? You can see everything through technology these days. So our major focus in solar is, one is the solar product, the primary product, the box, the auxiliary source. Second is how to make that solar product more attractive to consumers, like youth like me and you. Why would we want to make focus on ki meko ghar pe kaun sa panel lagana hai ya kya inverter lagana hai, mujhe koi interest nahi hai, mere ko apne iPhone se lena hai, apne kaam se lena hai. But trying to make the youth curious is trying to reach the youth through the medium of technology. And today we all know the youth or the oldies, everyone is attracted to their phones. So we're trying to bring all the technologies on the phone. You can monitor your inverter, your solar UPS, your solar productivity, everything through your phone.
And as we can see, like the street light is also something Sukam has in store.
This also.
Yeah. So can you explain something about this product, and like more importantly, that why do you think that in a country like India, such sort of product will be like important?
Okay, so India, if you see, governments have put a lot of street lights all over India, right? That's one of the biggest expenditures. We have highways, we have roads. Street lights plays a role in safety for those roads, right? We have the highest car accidents in the world. So even if we start with the initiative of putting street lights everywhere, we can reduce those accidents, right? But you have to understand that right now, all the street lights we put, the majority, they're powered by the grid. So they're not actually helping in the environment, they're not contributing. Even though in terms of technology, we have endless availability of solar streetlights today from private users, government users. Now the challenge I'll tell you is that the current technology we're using, people end to put the panel, the streetlight and a battery source. Wo battery ka source ek dabbe mein hota hai. Ab usme do challenge hai. When you have a normal LA or a SMA battery with a streetlight, it is much higher in probability to conk off. That will go in deep discharge and your light will not run. Second, that battery has big chance of getting stolen. Because it's just a box, you break the lock and a common man will just take it. So that's a big challenge, because that battery source, if it disappears, your light is gone forever. You put a new battery, a battery is a high investment. So in our light, what is the biggest unique factor which Sukam goes with every product? The battery is inbuilt. As you can see, I have the panel, I have the light, but there is no battery. So there is no way the consumer or any random person will make the effort to steal the battery from the light, because climbing that pole is a challenge. And mostly all solar street lights right now, their battery is installed at the bottom, so anyone can easily steal the battery. So government now has started realizing the potential of solar street lights, and they're doing a lot of projects where they're putting solar street lights in their offices, their factories, all over India, on the roads and highways of India. But making this project scalable is quite a challenge. And explaining the advantage of our product, as I told you, that whole advantage of having an inbuilt lithium-ion battery. Normal solar street lights use a lead acid battery or a SMA battery. We have a lithium-ion battery, the same battery you use in your iPhone or Samsung.
Okay, if we take into account, we know that solar industry is anyhow increasing manifolds after the new government came into power. So like, what is your view in the state of affairs in the solar industry in particular?
So I think new government, the Modi government, I'm a big fan of Modi personally. So he's one person who has the zeal of actually taking India somewhere else, which we all never thought of as a collective society. And the amount of new initiatives the new government is taking with solar. Tum jo bhi kehlo, marketing bhi ho, and calm na ho raha ho, but the thing is that that whole effort and that thought of actually focusing and emphasizing, that itself has created a boom in India. Because see, the government also, it's not easy for them. They say that they will bring 18,000 gaon mein bijli la denge. It's not that easy to bring bijli to the 18,000 villages, you know. And it's not their fault. It's not easy. The amount of effort that goes, bijli ke pole lagao, wire lagao, it's a big effort. But the fact that they make these statements with such threshold, that gives a whole new confidence to investors, to citizens of the country, to any common man. Ki chalo, at least the new government is taking initiatives where they're addressing the basics like water, electricity. And when we come to electricity, I feel, see, right now we're a very grid-dependent market. We're very dependent on the grid as a population. And we're a huge population, okay? We face challenges like overcrowding. Biggest challenge hamara ki as a population, abhi hum grid pe dependent hai. Koi ye nahi soch raha ki yaar hum solar se kitni dependency le sakte hain. So in the future, as I see it, is that hum wo grid dependency solar pe le jana chahte hain. Aaj ek time hota tha na, hum bolte the ki yaar gum laga de, paste laga de. Aaj banda bolta hai Fevicol laga de. Because Fevicol ne itna strong brand bana liya ki nobody says the word gum and paste. They say Fevicol ya Fevicol laga de. So Sukam wants to be that way in the industry. Koi kahe yaar grid se mujhe problem aa raha hai, grid aa raha hai, yaar tu Sukam laga de. Wherever there is solar, we want Sukam to be there.
And how do you view the growth rate of solar industry in India in the upcoming years?
I'll be very honest with you. We ourselves, if we talk about panels, products, we've grown at a good rate of almost more than 200%. So in terms of the way the government is going, if their support is there, which is already there, I think India will do great wonders with solar, where we'll actually produce as much as we need from solar one day. But that will take some time. If you see a country like Germany now, they have reached such a level where they have excess solar power. They can run their whole country on solar. Unhone itna solar laga diya ki unke liye excess ho gaya. They can shell it out to neighboring countries. So we can also have those phases. But it's all about the planning and the execution that is challenging. And it's quite challenging in this country.
So you think that the Make in India project that has been launched by our Prime Minister, yeah, so that will be beneficial for the solar industry?
Definitely.
Also,
I think it's beneficial for all industries, not just solar. First time the Prime Minister has taken initiative to highlight Indian companies, and how, by putting a steel tiger and writing Make in India in it, that itself does the job. See, the new Prime Minister, I have to say that one of his biggest strengths, and that will take our country to another level, is marketing. Ab jo bhi kao, whether you're a government or a private business, marketing is the key to reach people in today's time. Today, if you're buying some product, that company played a big role in getting that product to you through their marketing approach. So whether it's a government or a private sector, marketing is very important.
Okay, so it was indeed a pleasure to have with you us today. Thank you.